This episode brought to you by the only VPN I trust and use, Virtual Shield. Their suggestions that our credit scores might be based on our internet history in the near future. The same way that banks use data like income to judge credit eligibility now is how websites could use internet search history in the near future. I will not let my internet history be the judge of my credit score. That's why I use Virtual Shield. Just go to the link in the description and pinned comment and get Virtual Shield for 50% off today. Hey, welcome back, everybody. As we get closer to January 6th and the Republicans who are going to contest the election results, you're seeing the media kind of freak out and the Democrats freak out and starting to make charges of treason and sedition. You got CNN out there making ridiculous statements like, will Pence serve the Constitution or the devil? I mean, it's just gotten completely crazy. And the truth is that they have every constitutional right to challenge these election results. According to the Republicans, this is what they've put out there. We intend to vote on January 6th to reject the electors from disputed states as not regularly given and lawfully certified, unless and until that emergency 10-day audit is completed. I mean, it's gotten so crazy that Antifa, or at least left-wing extremists of some stripe, showed up to Joshua Hawley's house where his pregnant wife was and were, I guess, trying to intimidate them, letting them know that they know where they live so that Josh Hawley will, I guess, pull his support from objecting from the election results. Now, as usual, my focus here is the media's reaction to what the Republicans are doing. And it's typically partisan and typically hypocritical. Back in 2005, Democrats did this exact same thing and challenged the election results of George W. Bush, which is funny because they challenged him in 2021. And there was this all, you know, whole conspiracy theory centered around his election, and the media called it the Bush regime. And then he won again in 2004. And guess what? They challenged it again. But how do you think the media reacted when Democrats challenged election results in 2005?
Could there be a big pothole on the road to the Bush inaugural? Rumors of a congressional challenge to the election results are picking up steam on the eve of the certification of the Electoral College numbers.
You say it's just a protest, but it does bring attention to the problem of our system when it comes to voting here in the United States.
We've got an electoral system out there that doesn't work. We spend more on prison food in this country than elections.
What they want to do, in part, is to highlight what they call the massive disenfranchisement, as Representative Conyers said in the letter that you just presented, of voters in Ohio.
So many voters were disenfranchised, they said, that the Ohio vote and the result of the presidential election are still in doubt.
The outcome, of course, was not changed, delayed less than 3 hours. Though Republican leaders like Congressman DeLay and Ohio Republican Chair Bob Bennett treated it as if the Capitol had been pillaged by the Visigoths.
The Democrats knew that it was a pretty ceremonial objection, but regarded it as important.
Why did both sides treat this like political dynamite?
It would have been nice if both sides could get on a more bipartisan footing and look at these problems. I think Senator Boxer made an excellent point today when she said, we've got soldiers abroad dying for democracy, and we need to fix our own democracy here at home. And that's really what it's about.
As usual, and very predictably, it's different when Democrats do it. That's it for this one. Please hit that like button, share, and subscribe. If you want to support this channel, you can find all those links, as well as the links for a virtual VPN in the description and in the pinned comment. Thanks for watching. Keep coming back.